Special thanks to Motion Array for sponsoring today's video. So there have been a lot of updates when it comes to graphics inside Premiere Pro 2024. In this video, I'm going to be going over the new features. Let's dive in.
3, 2, 1.
So one of the new ways that you can import MOGRTs inside Premiere Pro 2024 is using folders inside Essential Graphics. Let's see how that works. So I'm inside Premiere Pro 2024, the latest version. Just make sure you are on the latest version before diving in here. And just to recap, inside Adobe Creative Cloud, it should be version 24.21. This is the one I'm currently using here. So back inside Premiere Pro, the old way of importing MOGRTs would be to either click the plus button in the bottom right-hand corner of Essential Graphics, or maybe going to the hamburger menu and going to manage additional folders. But the new way that you can import MOGRTs directly inside Essential Graphics is by using this plus button. And this will add a folder. You'll notice that your local templates are shown here, or your libraries. And as you can see, as you select the different check marks or the different folders, those MOGRTs will appear inside Essential Graphics. So this is a good way to manage your folders and only display the ones that you want to look at. So where do you get motion graphic templates at, or MOGRTs? Well, one website I really like to use a lot is called Motion Array. Motion Array has a ton of video assets like video templates, stock footage, photos, music, and sound effects. As you can see from their website, there's a lot of different tabs where you can explore different options. But in this video, we're going to be going over to the video templates inside the MOGRT section. You can see they have a lot of different MOGRTs to choose from. There's a lot of different filters, which makes it easy to find exactly what you're looking for. And what's really nice about Motion Array specifically is that they have version numbers. So if you're working inside a specific version of Premiere Pro, you can check that and it will only display the MOGRTs created for that version number. And even at the top, I like a lot of these filter settings where you can change it to most popular so you can see what other video editors are downloading, or even newest. So you can see what is brand new on the Motion Array website. There's a lot of new assets being uploaded all the time, so be sure to check it out. If you're interested to check out Motion Array, use my link down in the video description and you can save up to $50 off an annual plan. You can start for free today, so be sure to check it out. All right, let's see and download a MOGRT pack. So from the website here, I'm gonna download this one. This one looks pretty cool. It's called Kinetic Text Animation. So I'm just gonna click the download button and download it to my Finder window. So as you can see here, it downloads as a zip file. You'll just want to double click it to unzip it. And then you should see a MOGRT folder. And then here are the MOGRTs. So we have our MOGRTs here. And what we can do to add this to Premiere Pro is go back into the software and click this plus button. Once we click the plus button, it'll open up the file explorer or finder, and you can navigate to that folder. So for example, there's two different folders here. I'm gonna import the RGB ones. So I'm gonna click choose, and now you'll notice that RGB is selected here. So we can check that and we can see all of our different MOGRTs that we just imported. You can even rename these folders as well. You can right click and go to rename. So I'm gonna rename it Kinetic Text. That way it just describes it a little bit better of the type of MOGRT animation here. Okay, so one of the other cool features inside Premiere Pro 2024 is that now MOGRTs support video previews. Now this doesn't happen automatically, and there's a little bit of a caveat when it comes to this new feature. All the MOGRTs that were created in previous versions of Premiere Pro won't be supported with video previews, but any MOGRTs created inside Adobe After Effects or Premiere Pro 2024, version 24.2 or further in the future, have the ability to support video previews. Now you might be wondering, how do you enable video previews if you are working with past MOGRTs? I'm gonna show you how to do that inside Adobe After Effects. So let's say this MOGRT pack, you know, obviously doesn't support video previews yet, but say if I wanted this or one of these, let's say RGB01 to support a video preview, that way we can see the type of animation here and we can definitely tell what type of animation is being inside of these. That's the big thing with this new feature is right now, if you hover over with the mouse, you can't see a video preview. You don't know how this animation will look once you add it to your timeline. So let's see how we can edit these MOGRTs inside After Effects and get them to include video previews. To do that, I'm gonna go over to Adobe After Effects. And the first thing you'll wanna do is just go up to File, Open Project, and then navigate to the MOGRT that you want to create a video preview for and then click Open. This will basically convert it to an After Effects project. So you'll want to just click Extract and then click OK. And you'll notice that it'll open as an After Effects project here. So we can click on the MOGRT or the composition here. We can double click to open it up. And this is essentially the MOGRT. It's just in its After Effects native file here. So what we can do to re-export this back out of After Effects is easily go up to Window and go to Essential Graphics. This will display the window to export motion graphics out of. If you're interested on seeing how to actually use this to export motion graphics outside of After Effects, how to actually build all of these different layers in there, I did make a video going over that. I will link that right up there if you do want to check that process out. But we don't really have to do anything here. All we have to really do is just go down to Export Motion Graphics Template. We'll click Save to save the project. We'll save it inside that folder. And the big thing, once this window pops up, you'll just want to make sure that the checkbox is next to Include Video Preview. This will include that video preview inside the MOGRT template. And now we'll click Browse, and we'll just browse and save it and basically overwrite this MOGRT file here. So I'm just going to click on it to overwrite it and click Save. Click Replace, and then click OK. This will render it out, and once it's done, once we go back inside Premiere Pro, as we can see when we hover over it, you see the display of the video. So you can see how the actual file and the MOGRT file will look here once you add it inside your project or your timeline. So now we can simply click and drag this in, and now we have it on our project. We can click play, and we have our MOGRT. So that's a pretty cool new feature. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section below. There's a few other new features I did want to touch on in this video. One is support for emojis. So this is a pretty cool thing that came out in Premiere Pro recently. It's currently available for Mac, but it might not be available for Windows yet. But let's see how to work with emojis inside Essential Graphics. So to add an emoji as a text file, you can grab your type tool now and click out once inside your program monitor, and then go to Edit, and then Emojis and Symbols. And then you can select your favorite emoticon here. I'm gonna select the big smiley face since I like that one. I'm gonna click X, and now I'm gonna grab my selection tool and then just size this up here. Similar to any graphic file, it behaves the same way. But this is a pretty cool new feature, and you can now animate this, and that's another thing Motion Array is really good at, is having a lot of different text animations or different transitions that you can add to layers and clips. So if I go into our video transitions, you can see that Motion Array comes with a lot of different transitions already built in into Premiere Pro. I'm going to go into the shifter and just go into shifter bounce and just add this to the front. As you can see here, it just adds this little animation here. There's a lot of different things we can do with this. We can click on the transition and change inside effects controls. Maybe we want it from top to bottom. And we click play, play it back. You can see it kind of bounces down. We even have more advanced options like motion blur, so we can add some blur to it to kind of add some realness to the transition. And we can, of course, realign this so it hits the table. So maybe something like this. But that's pretty cool. Using Motion Array, you can add a lot of different transitions to emojis and different text files inside Adobe Premiere Pro. Now, one last feature I did want to mention inside Premiere Pro 2024 is the support for color fonts. So color fonts are essentially like normal fonts, but they're colorized. So they're already stylized. You can't edit the fill. And inside Premiere Pro 2024, you can now add these as text files, which is really cool. Let's see how that works. So I'm going to delete my emoticon and slide over. I already have this text file, and as you can see, it's a color font. It's not a normal font. You can see that it has several different colors in it. And Adobe currently supports a few different color fonts. This one specifically is called Gilbert Color. So when you go and search for Gilbert Color, you'll see the normal Gilbert font, and then you'll see Gilbert Color. And that indicates that this is a colored font. And same thing here, even with the color fonts, currently it's not supported as a MOGRT, so you can't use color fonts inside MOGRT templates. But similar to the emoji, you can always add in different transitions. I'm going to go into my Motion Array folder and go down to these cinematic transitions. So if I just click and drag this onto my color font, you can see that this easily adds a nice little animation to my graphic here. As you can see, it adds some effects here, some basic 3D and roughened edges. And that's what's really nice about these templates and transitions, is it saves time in trying to create that from scratch. But currently, this is really the only way to animate colored fonts, is by using transitions. But probably down the line, if I had to guess, MOGRTs will probably support these colored fonts in the future. And I will link down in the video description the available color fonts for Premiere Pro and the Adobe products. So I'm just going to paste this in here just to show you guys. So this is the link that discusses the new color fonts. So these are the new fonts that you can use inside Premiere Pro. Gilbert's one of them, but feel free to go check it out. I will link this down in the video description. But those are the cool graphic updates inside Premiere Pro 2024. Now, one other update that did come out recently was enhanced speech. If you haven't seen my video going over that and testing that out, I do highly recommend it. It's a really cool feature. I'll link that video right up there. But otherwise, thank you so much for watching, and we'll see you guys in the next video.